Now we have gone through the angle between the two lines and the formula was in terms of cos theta. Now we are just writing the formula in terms of sine theta and tangent theta. Okay, sine form or tangent form. Now let L1, M1, N1 and L2, M2, N2 be the direction cosines of two given lines. Now remember, these are the direction cosines. Don't mess up with the direction ratios. Okay, so angle between two lines it is given by cos theta is equal to L1 L2 plus M1 M2 plus N1 N2. Okay, or cos theta is equal to summation for, we can write it L1, L2. Okay. Now for the sine formula. Now, sine form now. Sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos square theta. Now in place of this 1, what we can write it? Just look here. Can we write in place of this 1 L1 square plus M1 square plus N1 square with L2 square plus M2 square plus N2 square? This is what? This is 1 minus cos square theta we are having. So here it is now L1 L2 plus M1 M2 plus N1 N2 whole square. Now L1 square plus M1 square plus N1 square is equal to 1 or is equal to L2 square plus M2 square plus N2 square. So 1 times 1, that is what? That is 1 itself. 1 times 1 is 1. Now to this, what further we can write it? Further to this we can write it now L1 M2 minus L2 M1 whole square plus M1 L2 minus M2 N1 whole square plus N1 L2 minus N2 L1 whole square by Lagrange's identity. Just now we have done it. Is it clear? So to this now what we can write it? We can write it this as summation for L1 M2 minus L2 M1, we can write like this one, okay, whole square. Is it clear? Now what we are having, we want now sine theta. Now we can write it, sine theta is equal to plus minus square root for summation for L1 M2 minus L2 M1 whole square. Okay, now tangent form. We can write it now. Tan theta is sin theta upon cos theta. Therefore, tan theta is equal to plus minus square root for summation for L1 M2 minus L2 M1 whole square upon summation for L1 L2 cos theta, that is summation for L1 L2. So, one is in the sine form and the formula is in the tangent form.